Hello and welcome to IT Convergence User Productivity Kit tutorial series. This is a demonstration of how to use glossaries to define specialized terms or terms that require further clarification in the Oracle UPK developer. Glossaries can be used to provide definitions for specialized terms unique to a company or terms that require further clarification for users. Each glossary document contains a list of terms and definitions, where the definitions are attachments to which the term links. Multiple glossary documents can be created and used for different parts of the content. The use of glossaries involves three steps. The first step is to create a glossary document using the glossary editor. Next is to assign one or more glossaries to the content using the properties toolpane, which can be done from the library, outline editor, and web page editor. The third step is glossary markup, or updating glossary links. When you update glossary links, the developer searches the text in your content for occurrences of glossary terms. When it finds a term that matches the selected markup conditions, it creates a link to the attachment specified as the definition link. To create a new glossary in the library, go to the File menu, point to New, and choose Glossary. The glossary editor will launch in a new tab. When you have created a new glossary document, the next step is to add terms to the glossary and link the definitions. To add a glossary term to a glossary document, type the term in the empty glossary term cell. A glossary term can include both spaces and special characters, and there is no limit to the length of a term. However, a glossary term must be unique on a case-insensitive basis within a glossary document. In the definition link cell in the same row, select an attachment for a definition link. Any type of attachment, such as package file, web page, or URL, can be used as a definition link. To select a package file or a web page as a definition link for a glossary term, click the LOV button in the definition link cell for the term. When the Edit Definition Link dialog box opens, click on the Create Link icon. In the Link to Pane, select Document in Library. Or click the Create New Web Page icon to create a new web page and link to it in one step. Navigate the library to the folder containing the package file or web page to which you want to link. Select the desired package file or web page document. Click OK or press Enter. To select a URL as a definition link for a glossary term, click the LOV button in the definition link cell for the term. When the Edit Definition Link dialog box opens, click on the Create Link icon. Select the URL icon in the Link to Pane. In the Address field, type or paste the target URL. Click the Go icon or press Enter. When the glossary term has been created, the next step is to set the markup conditions. By default, Match Whole Word is selected and Match Case is not selected. Change a setting by checking or clearing the appropriate checkbox. The new glossary document can be saved to any folder in the library. Once the glossary has been created, it can be assigned to one or more documents in the library. These can be done in two ways, through manual assignment and through inheritance from the document's parent. To assign a glossary to a document, you first need to display the properties toolpane. From the library or outline editor, select the document to which you want to assign a glossary. In the properties toolpane, click the glossary property. Click the LOV button. Navigate the library to the folder containing the desired glossary. Click open or press enter. The last step in using glossaries is to update glossary links. You can update glossary links from the glossary editor, the library, or the outline editor. To update glossary links from the glossary editor, open the glossary document. On the Edit menu, choose Update Glossary Links. The developer searches all documents to which the glossary is assigned and updates links for glossary terms found in those documents. To update a glossary link from the library or outline editor, select the document from which you want to update glossary links. On Edit menu, choose Update Glossary Links. The developer searches all selected documents and their directly related children and updates links for glossary terms found in those documents to which a glossary is assigned. You can at any time add, edit, and delete terms in the glossary editor. To edit a glossary, open the glossary document that you want to edit from the library. The glossary document selected opens in the glossary editor and you can make the changes needed. Save and close the glossary document. When you close a glossary document to which you have made and saved changes, you are prompted to update glossary links. Click Yes to update links for all documents to which the glossary is assigned, or click No to close the glossary without updating links. This concludes our tutorial on how to use glossaries to define specialized terms or terms that require further clarification in the Oracle UPK developer. On the behalf of IT Convergence, I would like to thank you for your time and invite you to join IT Convergence YouTube channel where you can learn more about user productivity kit features and functions. Thank you.